Hi, so this is gonna be our train at home high intensity conditioning. What we're gonna do, we're gonna go through all the little pieces so everybody, especially the beginners, know exactly what to do. So the first exercise is the Amara exercise. Okay, so the Amara, if you remember from class, you go angle one, angle two, angle two to the wrist. Here you chamber for a rack to the eyes, your right hand step back. Redondo to the wrist, step back in, and abanico to the temple. Here you're gonna parachute to the kneecap and come back here on guard, okay? It goes like this, and back. Obviously, it's the same thing on the left side. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, around and back on guard. For your Tabata protocol, of course, you're gonna go faster and you're not gonna spend so much time going back on guard. You'll be here and you go full speed. And you keep going. Same thing on the left. For the shadow boxing, I like to wear my gloves. You don't have to, but it kind of put me in the mood. So I wear my gloves for shadow box. If you have a punching heavy bag at home, feel free to switch between shadow and heavy bag. Basically, you're just gonna move full speed. I'm going slow here for the demo. Make sure your hands go back to the cheek every single time and make sure you mix punching, striking, and evading. A lot of time when we shadow box or when we use the heavy bag, people just punch, 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 and they forget, you know, to cover, to move, to block, to dodge. So you need to put everything together. Also, what I want, especially for the advance, is to practice your footwork. So here, make sure you step forward once in a while, just to change guard with some forward pressure and keep moving, okay? For the skipping rope round, first, I suggest you get a really good skip rope. That's the one that I use, okay? It's a Rogue. You can use any brand. You can find them on Amazon, anywhere online, I guess, okay? Make sure it's long enough. Many people have a too short of a skipping rope. When you step on it with your front leg, they have to be above your nipples line. If they're underneath, it's too short. It has to be quite long, longer than what most people think. The beginner skipping move is very simple. Legs together and just single under. Okay, you go as fast as you can without losing it. When you have that, you can start using different kind of footwork here in the front, here tapping. Okay, when you get fast enough, you can start with your knee or you can try to double unders. Double unders meaning going twice underneath in one jump. The mistake most people do with a double under, they try to get their feet under their butt. So it looks like this and it doesn't work. So you're gonna start by jumping as high as you can and then you're gonna double under. All right, 20 seconds, full speed. Okay, for the double sticks, we're gonna do a figure eight for the beginners and the intermediates. For those who don't know how to do a figure eight, it's a simple Sinawali six that you remember from class. And you make it shorter and shorter until your wrists basically stay together. That's my figure eight. So you're gonna play with that, you're gonna move around. What I want is movement. You can double the redondo here, okay, and do whatever you want. For the advanced black belts, of course, you go free flow coming back to the figure eight once in a while. Just move your stick here. Okay, move both stick at the same time, of course, and go full speed for 20 seconds. For the shadow knife fighting, exactly the same as shadow boxing, except you have a knife in your hand. You can here stab, you can cut. Don't forget to use the alive hand. Here you can flip, go into a reverse grip. Come here, move. Don't forget to punch, cut, stab, change guard, go back to the original grip. You can change hand anytime you want. and just keep going. Push-ups, well, I guess everybody knows how to do push-ups. Make sure you don't open your elbow too much. That's gonna put too much pressure on your shoulders. Try to have your elbows going toward your body when you do your push-ups. Here, the nose touches the floor and back up, okay? And you go for as many as you can for 20 seconds. If before the end of the 20 seconds you can't go anymore, you put your knees on the floor and you keep going. You don't stop, you keep going. For the free flow solo baston round, you are going to, for beginners, practice your basic angles in order first. Then in this order, if you want, here, whatever you want to do, okay? The goal is to go as fast as you can for 20 seconds. If you're intermediate, advanced, or black belt, obviously you do whatever you want. You can play with the Amara, you can change hand, you can box, of course, with your stick, you can grab for knee, push, you can pretend you're throwing and just play with the stick, right hand, left hand, just move. Okay, for the hand switch, for those who are not familiar with, you can switch here underneath the armpit, change grip, okay, that's a very good, efficient change, gives you power, change the distance. You can simply change grip here, back fist, and there you go on the left. You can go behind the triceps here, okay, you can go across here, okay. There's many ways for you to change grip here along the spine. Just play with it and move. Don't forget to punch, scratch, grab. There's many things you can do with your stick. Full speed for 20 seconds. For the uppercut loop, it's very simple. You're just gonna practice full speed uppercuts. Make sure it's not the shoulder that generates the move, but the hips, and the elbow leaves the body only at the very last second. Here, as fast as you can for 20 seconds. For the superhero push-ups, it's gonna be a little more tricky for some people. If you can't do them, you stay in plank, perfect plank for a few seconds, maybe your hands a little further than a regular plank. If you can, you're gonna go very slow with your elbows and forearm on the floor, and then push with your palms up. Okay, so that's the idea of the superhero push-up. It's quite challenging for most people. All the way down, push. All the way down, push. What you don't want is this. You don't want to help yourself with your butt or with some body movement. It's a pure straight plank. And you just push up with the strength of your triceps, okay? This is gonna give you tremendous punching power. Very good for your triceps, very good for punching. For the jumping squat series, just make sure that you land lightly on your toes first, then all the way down to your heel and jump back up. If you land on your heel, you're gonna damage your tendon, you're gonna damage your knee, so be careful with that. You can just jump with straight legs if it's easier for you to start with, but for the intermediates, advanced and above, I would prefer you to jump and knee. Jump and knee every time. For the shadow kickboxing, make sure you don't over snap your knees when you kick in the air. That's where, if you have a heavy bag, it's better. I don't really like to kick in the air. If you do have a heavy bag, that's what you're gonna use. If you don't, well, you can still shadow box when you're kickboxing, but make sure you go not too hard on your joint. When you high kicks especially, you can punch, you can elbow, you can knees. Make sure you go back on guard every time. Step for forward pressure, okay? Again, when you kick, not too hard. It's more of a stretching than really hard kicking when you practice shadow kickboxing here. But when you have a bag, you can start putting a little more power here. Just move away with your bags, mix again the punching, the blocking, evade, knee, kick, everything wrap up together. For the knee loop, very simple, you're just gonna knee, you stay on site, you don't move too much, and you go as fast as you can, switching leg every time. So you'll be here. And you go as fast as you can for 20 seconds. For the jab cross loop, same thing as the uppercut, you go as fast as you can with simple jab cross. The movements are generate from the hips. All right, for the stretching, it's freezing here this morning. It's early morning in South Carolina, so I'm not gonna push too hard. I don't wanna hurt my joints and my muscles. So depending on where you are and if it's warmer or colder, make sure you adapt your stretch. It's easier to stretch when it's warm than it is when it's cold, so be very careful. Normally, you just finish your Tabata, so you're warmed up completely. Let's go and stretch. First one here with your elbows, you're gonna push your knees to the outside. Roll from right to left. From here, put your hands on the floor and try to extend your legs if you can. Same thing on the side here along the leg. Breathe, move to the other side gently. Back to the middle here and gently back up. Here, you can hold your hand to a wall if you want, you don't have to. We're gonna stretch the quads. You're gonna bring your heel to your buttocks and you're gonna put your knees together, both legs, both thighs on the same plane. If you're here, it's not gonna work. You have to be flat here. And from this movement, it's not so much how much you can pull this leg, it's how much you can move your hips forward without going away from your butt here. So move forward. Okay, same thing on the other side, obviously. You're here and move forward your hips. Push your hips forward by keeping your heel to your butt. And release. From this position, we're gonna go to a lunge. Here, go as deep as you can. You start on your toes back there, then you move on the top of the foot to accentuate the stretch a little bit. And from this position, we're gonna go to a triangle stretch, which can be here. You make a triangle between this leg and the floor, and you go down, always breathing deeply. Or you can do the same triangle stretch with both legs extended here and go down, okay? Obviously, we do everything on the other side. We start with the lunge here. Now, foot flat on the floor. You stay as long as you need. Triangle stretch here or here. Okay, it's important to be comfortable with the stretch you're doing. Okay, from this position, we're gonna turn back in the middle here. Go a little lower, a little deeper than we did when we were almost standing. Here, same thing on the side. And I do it pretty fast, so it's not too long for you to watch that video, but of course you stay as long as you need. And back in the middle. Here I'm gonna sit on one leg. Try to keep your heel here on the floor and you're on your heel here with the other leg. Okay, here you're gonna push your knee, your bended knee, with your forearm or triceps, and stretch and go as low as you can. Same thing on the other side, of course. Here. For the splits, you don't need to split completely. You can if you want, but you can go from a triangle stretch and go as low as you can. For those who are flexible enough, when you want to practice your split, make sure your toes are completely pointed backward. If you're here, you're gonna destroy your knee, so it has to be here. And only from this position, you can split. Okay, same thing on the other side, of course. Here, and just split. And for the front split, you're gonna start here, okay? And gently, the idea is to go on your heels and to sit. It's not easy with the carpet, I'm not sliding enough, but that should do. And you're here. From this position, you take as much time as you need. Relax your muscles here. Don't forget to breathe as deep as you can. You're gonna start by going forward. Not too much at the beginning. You need to warm up not only your legs, but also your back, your spine. Okay, roll from side to side. Now you're gonna go on one leg here. You're gonna grab your toes if you can. If you can't, grab your leg, it's okay. And you're just gonna go lower. Don't forget to breathe. Same thing on the other side here. You go a little deeper as you breathe. Now, you're gonna go in a half circle position, almost like a bobsled, from your right leg to your left and up. Down, half circle and up. And you're gonna do that several times until you can feel your abductor muscles loosening up. Okay, one more time here. That will help you to go lower here on that position and eventually put your forehead on the floor. Okay. Next move here, we're gonna go for the butterfly. You're gonna put your feet together, grab them with your hands, and or butterfly your knees here in order to relax the hips. Or you're gonna grab your foot here with the right hand, your left foot with the left hand, and push your knees down with your elbows. Release. And final exercise, back to the quads muscle here. You're gonna knee in a seiza position, put your hands here on the floor, and push your hips forward. Okay, if that is not enough of a stretch for you, you can put your elbows on the floor and do the same thing. Or if you're very flexible, you can lie down completely and still focusing on pushing the hips forward. 5 move. Here we're gonna do the famous yoga downward dog. Here your heels are on the outside, your legs are straight, your back is straight, and you're gonna push in your palms and relax your head. Okay, the idea is to make a V shape and to release the tension between the scapulars and the entire posterior chains. And that's it for the stretch. Okay, there's 8 different moves and it starts here. First, push up, palm up, thumbs up. That's very important. Look at my thumbs. I hope you can see them here. Second, press down. Same thing. The thumbs are separate from the rest of the hand. Number 3, press down even further. You don't need to go all the way down. It's not a stretch. Number 4, split hand in the front. Here, one side, and the other. Next, split hand from the rear. I'm gonna turn so you can see. One hand is in the rear here. Same thing on the other side. Next, I'm going back in your direction. Bow and arrow. Next, full stretch on the horse. That's how they call it. Don't ask me why. Look at my thumbs. They're always separate from my palms. And the last one, look at your heels. So the idea, I'm gonna turn again so you can see, is for me to be able to see both my heels. So I'm gonna turn as much as I can and bend just enough so I can see my heels. That is very, very good for for your spine health. Look and bend. And that's the end of the eight move. You breathe down. And you do that at least two times.
This looks like a job for me, so everybody just follow me, 'cause we need a little controversy, 'cause it feels so empty without me. I created a monster, 'cause nobody wants to see Marshall no more. They want Shady, I'm Chopped Liver. Well, if you want Shady, this is what I'll give you. A little bit of weed mixed with some hard liquor, some vodka that'll jumpstart my heart quicker than a shock when I get shocked at the hospital by the doctor when I'm not cooperating, when I'm rocking the table while he's operating. You waited this long to stop debating, 'cause I'm back, I'm on the rag and ovulating. I know that you got a job, Miss Cheney, but your husband's heart problem's complicating. So the FCC won't let me be, or let me be me, so let me see. They try to shut me down on MTV, but it feels so empty without me. So come on, get bum on your lips, fuck that, come on your lips, and some on your tits, and get ready, 'cause this shit's about to get heavy. I just settled all my lawsuits. Fuck you, give it. Fix it, and I'm tuning in, and I'm gonna enter in, and I'm under your skin like a splinter.